Okay, thank you for sitting down with me, Marie. I appreciate you coming all the way down to Culver City.
Yes, it was far. I had to wait in traffic, but I thought this was definitely worth it.
Thanks.
Yeah.
Okay, so you're a professional, and you know that I struggle a lot with professionalism.
Mm-hmm.
You're a real journalist, like a bona fide journalist, and I'm trying to do something a little bit more meaningful than my last gig. And on the show, I'm exploring lots of different topics, talking to more responsible people, not just celebrities, and not being just a buffoon all the time. I stopped taking my top off like a year ago. And
I see you take your top off a lot on social media.
No, I haven't in almost a year. So, I mean, you're looking
those
at
those are
old
pictures.
I mean, how often are you looking at them is the real question.
I mean, but just when my kids show them to me.
Okay.
So that's over.
That's over.
That was
a phase. This is like Chelsea 2.0, if you will.
Okay.
I interview politicians on this show, a lot of scientists.
Right.
And I don't have a journalism degree.
Mm-hmm.
So
a lot of people on TV now don't have a journalism degree.
It seems like that.
That's right. So that shouldn't be intimidating to you.
Okay. I want to know what you know. Like, what are the, like, hard journalism rules that you abide by?
I abide by facts.
But I don't, in my situation,
so you don't have any of that. So
any.
We'll throw that out.
Okay.
The fact thing we'll throw out. So next, I try to listen.
Yeah.
So most people, even like on live television, when they're interviewing somebody, they're usually looking down
at
their
definitely.
Question. You never do that,
no.
Which is great.
Thank you.
So I think when you ask a question, you actually have to pretend that you're really interested in what the person's saying.
Even if it's not interesting.
Even if it's not interesting. And then you just can't interrupt them. Sometimes you interrupt, and we'll go over.
So I have a question. So do you ever get shaky leg syndrome? Like when you're nervous sometimes? I have to just take beta blocker sometimes if I'm going to speak without drinking.
You should not drink before you speak.
I always...
You should not drink before you ever interview either.
I don't really drink before I interview.
Really? Yeah.
Primarily. Oh, what about also like maintaining professionalism? Like if I want to flirt with my guests, a lot of times I'll, you know, I've definitely dated guests before or hooked up. I mean, they're actors, but I thought, fuck it. I mean, excuse me.
You hook up with your guests?
Well, like
that's totally unprofessional.
Yeah.
Yeah, like I don't know anybody who does that.
Yeah, you do. I'm sure a lot of those people are.
No.
Okay.
No. Do you ever feel bad when you interrupt or you say, like, the F word in the middle of an interview?
I do now.
You do
that you're
now.
Bringing it up. Do you have an example?
Yes,
I know exactly
I do.
What you're talking
yes.
about.
Yes, let me get it out.
And I was on your show.
Many times.
Do you know how many times?
Too many.
28 times.
Well,
28.
It's really hard to watch myself like this.
18 were memorable. That's what it was. That's what I remember. Yes, yes, yes.
Go fuck yourself. See, this is a different set of circumstances. That's Jay, and I know Jay very well, and he can take that. I would never say that to Barack Obama or Hillary Clinton.
Okay, so then you have, like, a certain journalism side with those people.
Yes.
And then you're kind of irreverent someplace else.
Yeah, I should get one personality. Like,
yeah, I think maybe we should get one personality, one look.
One look?
Yeah, because a lot of the interviews that I looked at in preparing for this, you had lots of different looks. See, now this picture right here.
Wow, you wear navy blue all the time.
But look and see, what's that coming out of that slit?
Oh, my goodness.
You have something coming out of the slit. So I'm looking at the slit.
Oh,
yeah, you can see your breasts in that shirt.
No, that was an accident.
And you're always with your leg under your ass. I don't know what that's about.
That's to make people comfortable.
Why does it you think it makes people comfortable for you to sit on your leg?
I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know either. So what is the look there? So you have a t-shirt on that says Rush.
But I thought my one look was like rock and roll t-shirts and pants or like a skirt.
You like that. So that when you look at that, you're like, I love that.
Yeah.
But it just changes every minute. So maybe this is your look, but you have so many different looks.
Yeah. Okay.
So I can't tell which look is which.
Okay, so I'll just find one look.
Okay, you'll find one look. These are very small little things, but you're going to listen, which is the most important thing.
Yeah.
And you're kind of walking a fine line between being a journalist and a personality. But by and large, I think you're doing pretty good.
Thank you.
The way.
That was like the second compliment.
You're welcome.
Can I ask you what you think are some of the interviews that have changed the course of history?
Well, I think the big interview used to do that. I think, you know, there are kind of legendary interviews, Frost Nixon, Barbara Walters, talking to Monica Lewinsky.
Do you like to be interviewed?
No.
You don't?
No. Do you like to be interviewed?
Yeah, I don't mind it.
You do?
I like it. I like talking about myself.
You do?
Obviously. I mean, that's the biggest problem we have on this show.
Maybe that's why you don't really like to listen. But I probably could take some advice from you in that. Like, I was talking to my daughter, and she's like, wow, what, you have nothing in common with her. I go, yeah, no, I do. And she's like, she just doesn't give a what anybody thinks.
Do you really care about what people think?
Well, I have, like, a little bit of a, not a good girl in me, but I do, like, I
You're
wouldn't
Catholic.
Say, like, yeah, I'm Catholic, and I wouldn't say,
that's
like.
That's your problem. Okay, so what about Barbara Walters? Like,
yes.
How would you grade her as an interviewer?
I think she certainly paved the way for every single woman that's on television.
Yeah, of course.
When we talk about a good interviewer, look at her.
You seem to have made a strategic and historic choice to become much closer to the West, to the United States. Is the Cold War over?
Probably it was over a long time ago.
Pause. Okay.
What a fucking asshole.
So you wouldn't want to interview him?
No, I would.
You would? Mm-hmm. Yes. So now, let's just think, if you had a chance to interview him, would you sit with your foot under your leg?
No, I wouldn't. No. I would put my foot in his ass.
You'd put your foot? All right, so that's good to know. Okay, so with a guy like that, you have to not only have a lot of back knowledge.
Yeah.
Right, everything from the Soviet Union, now Russia, to capitalism versus communism. So if you're going to interview somebody like that.
I wouldn't even go. I can't.
Yes,
that's too much studying. I mean, I don't even know all about that.
You'd have to read up.
Yeah, I would read up.
You'd
absolutely.
Read up.
I so like to do the research, and I do read a lot. I'm not as stupid as I sound.
No, I don't think you sound stupid at all.
Oh, thank you.
You have to change your thought process. Three compliments.
Yeah, that was the third
For
one.
Me, zero.
Oh,
but that's
I'll
okay.
give you some in a minute.
Okay, in a minute. But anyway, so here's Castro. Would you like to interview Castro?
Oh, my gosh. Wow.
Doing? How do you know they wouldn't like a capitalist society?
Oh, my gosh. Look at you.
Because I lived in a capitalist society, and I know they wouldn't like to live there.
Do you agree with the president that you would not like a capitalist society because he's seen one and he didn't like it?
You were interviewing him in front of all those people?
Yes. But he's one of those people who I did, like, a three-hour interview like this, and then he's like, let's go into the streets.
Weren't you hungry? I have to eat.
I was hungry, and I was also, he decided to do the interview at 1 o'clock in the morning.
Weren't you, didn't you want to say after an hour and a half, okay, I got this?
No, I mean, like, you know, this is a legendary figure, controversial, interesting.
Yeah, I guess you have a point. I guess I just have to work on my stamina.
I think you have a lot of stamina.
Thanks.
Yeah. So when you're interviewing somebody like this,
okay.
What about the dog?
Well, I mean, what do you think?
That was distracting. I had trouble paying attention to you a couple times when I was watching the dog.
Yeah.
But maybe that doesn't distract you. I'm just asking, it doesn't distract
no.
you.
No, okay. Do you think I should put him down?
No.
Oh.
But I think if you get Mrs. Clinton, maybe you shouldn't bring him with her.
This is why it's helpful to get notes from you, because I do like advice from people I respect, such mm-hmm. as you. That's a compliment from me
one.
To you.
Okay, one.
Because it's so impossible to watch myself. I hate my voice, I hate my face, everything looks gross, I look bloated, or if I had too much to drink the night before, which is almost every day. It's so hard to critique myself. That's why it's good for you to be able to critique, because you are not seeing the same things I see.
I see a lot of the same things as you see.
Okay.
Yeah, I see some of those things, but I don't think you're actually going to change anything from what I tell you.
Why?
Because I don't think you need to. I think you're doing really well.
That's nice of you to say.
It's true, because journalism is about getting the facts, but you're not really trying to get facts. You're trying to have fun.
That's
and you're
right.
succeeding. So actually, you don't need to really learn anything from me.
No,
other than
I'm gonna
listening.
No, I'm going to do what we talked about with my hair, my clothes, and the listening. And
Perfect.
I'm going to be a quieter interviewer. Right? And not just interrupt when I have the first opportunity.
And also to think about,
and
like,
even if they're not interesting and I'm trying to make them more, because a lot of the times when I'm interrupting is I'm trying to get them to be more interesting.